Okay, it is official. My first time riding the Indian Scout Bobber. It's a 2019. I'm gonna get on it, take it for a ride, and then we'll discuss my likes, my dislikes, and everything in between. But I must say, before we start, it is a nasty looking little bike. It's beautiful. It's tough, but we're gonna see if the ride equals the look. Coming at you. I don't like, and let's talk about what people Indian is targeting with this bike, and did they hit their mark? The 2019 Indian Scout Bobber is a what is one of the more entry-level bikes for the American motorcycle company Indian. The Bobber is just kind of a cut-down, stripped-out version of the Scout. Sits a little bit lower. It's got the chopped fenders, the big fat front tires, and with it sitting lower, it has a little bit less suspension travel. Now, while the Scout Bobber is not my typical type of motorcycle that I review, certainly not a touring model, it definitely has its place amongst the motorcycle world. And the Indian Motorcycle Company, an American company, has worked really hard, I think, to hit their mark here. This bike is a perfect motorcycle for someone who's looking to ride around town, bang the inner streets, but not really go on a cross-country trip. This isn't what I would want to take on a cross-country journey. Now, with that said, it can be done. Believe me, there's somebody out there who's commenting in the, right now, who's done it. I understand you can do it. It's just not the ideal situation. This is a great bike for inner city, where you've got a lot of traffic, you've got a lot going on. Very small bike can fit in between California. This would be a great lane-splitting bike. Another great thing about this bike is the fact that it sits so low. Sitting that low makes it perfect for anybody with the shorter inseam. They're gonna be able to reach the ground with their feet very easily. It's probably one of the lowest bikes I've ever sat on. Now, with being low comes some negatives, and that's suspension travel. They've reduced the already low suspension travel of the Scout. And now with the Scout Bobber, which is, you know, an American version of Cafe Racer, I would say, or an equivalent to, the lowered suspension travel, you are gonna notice it. On these streets, as I was riding along, as I hit bumps, they were jarring, they were difficult. You are definitely riding a light, aggressive motorcycle with very little suspension travel. That would probably be my number one complaint on this motorcycle. It does ride fairly rough. The front brakes is a single disc brake. It does ample, it stops the bike good, but you need to grab the brake like you mean it if you want to get it to stop. Once you do, she'll stop without issue. I found the bike unbelievably balanced and nimble. I rode it inside the city, which is its intended environment in my opinion. And it did fairly well. I loved it. It was very quick in acceleration from stoplight to stoplight. The power plant on this motorcycle is a liquid-cooled 100 horsepower motor. And when you put it on a bike this small, what you get is instant response. Now, me being 6'2", 220 pounds, I find myself a bit big for this motorcycle. I felt a little bit overbearing on top of it. I felt like maybe I was just a little bit too much man for the bike. Not saying the bike's not manly, just saying I'm a bigger guy, it's a smaller bike, I'm used to riding touring models, so it felt small for me. Although it was fun, it's big enough that if I was living in a city, I would have a bike like this just for riding around the city on a daily commute. Maybe bring the handlebars up a little bit for myself and a few other things. The forward controls made it nice for me. But what I think this bike was really intended for is the looks, the styling. I can't tell you how many people have stopped already just on my test ride today to take pictures of it, tell me what a beautiful bike it is. I had it sitting next to my Harley, I had it sitting next to my Indian Dark Horse and another bike, and everybody came up and wanted to look at this bike and talk about how cool it was. So the styling factor, they've definitely nailed. Let me tell you about some of the things I like about the styling. One, I love the look of the engine cases. The way that engine sits inside that frame is a beautiful thing to me. And even the way it's molded around the primary, I don't know what it is, but it's got a very industrial, futuristic, crazy good look. You pair that with a not too much chrome, some brushed aluminum, and you've got yourself a motorcycle that truly is the style of what I like. A solo seat, not set up for two up. It doesn't even come with the passenger pegs to put a passenger on this bike. The solo seat is very stylish and very cool, well stitched, a cool vintage look to it. Not that much cushion, but again, for what this bike is made for, it's very ample, and it definitely hits that target of being a cool looking motorcycle, which I think is one of the biggest goals with this bike. Pair that with the chopped up fenders, the fat tires with the chunky treads, the big headlight bezel, and just the overall thick metal look of this bike, and you've got something that really has a cool city vibe meets maybe some sort of a doomsday aggressive. It's a pretty cool motorcycle. At first glance, I didn't think I was gonna like the low slung mirrors hanging down underneath, but they are the adequate size, and Indian definitely did their homework on where to place them because they actually worked phenomenally well. I've never had an upside down mirror that worked quite as well as it does with the stance on this motorcycle. Now, you're not gonna get any power locks or any of those frills. Your key is gonna be just a standard old key. Old school, traditional, no key fobs, no batteries to go dead. Definitely a bonus in some areas, but I always, of course, love my key fobs, my keyless starting, all that, not having to mess with this. Put this in my pocket and just carry it all day, come and go for my bike as I please. The Scout Bobber, a little bit more traditional. You know, it was my first time riding a Scout Bobber, and it rode pretty much what I had expected it would ride like. Maybe just a little bit faster than what I would have thought. I was pretty impressed with the speed. 100 horsepower on a bike this light definitely makes for a very fun ride. If you're looking for a motorcycle that has exceptional style, that is nimble, agile around town, great for those short rides, and has plenty of power, this may just be your motorcycle. That engine redlines at over 8,000 RPM, nearly double what its bigger brother, the Chieftain that I ride, redlines at. And getting it to those upper RPMs is worth doing. It actually has ample power and a decent power band, even in those higher RPMs. Right from the factory, you've got a pretty cool lightweight motorcycle at the entry level for Indian. I would say the biggest competition for this bike, or comparison to this bike for other American-made motorcycles, is going to be the Harley-Davidson Sportster, probably the 48 model. And comparing the two to each other is certainly worth doing. Maybe I'll do a breakdown side-by-side comparison of the two, because they're definitely both going after the same market. And I have to say, I think Indian has done a great job hitting the target with this bike. But that lower suspension and lower ride height, that is for the younger or lighter man, certainly. All right, y'all, I hope you enjoyed this straight to the point review. Of course, I gotta give a shout out to who provided me this bike for the review, and that is Indian Motorcycles of Oklahoma City. Thank you so much for providing me this bike. Don't hesitate to go down there, talk to those boys and girls yourself, and maybe even take one of these girls for a spin. And that is the absolute best advice I can give you. Get out and ride more bikes, look at these reviews, see what you might be interested in, but then get out and test them yourself, because you never know what you're gonna like until you try it. And I think before purchasing a motorcycle, the best thing people can do is get out and take them on rides in the scenarios where they are gonna wanna be riding them. All right, y'all, that's it for my advice, my review, my breakdown on the 2019 Indian Scout Bobber. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Hope I didn't drag it out too long. And if you enjoy our content, our videos, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button on YouTube. We are almost to 100,000 subscribers, and on Facebook, we are this close to 500,000. So give us that share, and let your friends know that there's always some good motorcycle content right here on our channel. We'll talk to y'all later.